my boss. He saw me slip out early. He's come here to fire me.
You got here the same time you always do.
I know. I always leave early. I refuse to be one of those little cowardly clock watchers, Diane. As soon as my supervisor turns his head, I always slip out the heating duct.
How would he know you're here?
The company's full of spies.
Really?
Yeah, they know everything about you. They even keep track of your sex habits. Thank God I don't have any. He's coming this way.
Cliffy, cover for me.
Yeah, Roger.
Wait a minute. Excuse me, wasn't that Norm Peterson?
No, there's no Norm Peterson here. As a matter of fact, I don't even know a Norm Peterson.
Are you sure? The man that just ran into the men's room with his jacket pulled over his head?
Absolutely not. Probably just somebody who looked like Norm Peterson. Who I don't know.
I see.
Uh-huh.
And, what's this on the floor? Foam insulation from our heating duct. My information is correct. Peterson, you in here?
Were you talking to me?
What are you doing in there?
Sir, this is awfully close to being an invasion of privacy, darn it.
I want to talk to you. I'll wait outside.
No, sir. I know what you're probably going to do to me, and this does seem like the appropriate place for it.
All right. Peterson, we've been making some organizational changes in the company, and starting tomorrow, we want you to be our corporate killer.
Guy who fires people?
That's right. You see, we decided that terminating employees puts too much stress on our executives. We think you'll be perfect.
Why me?
Because studies have shown that it's particularly humiliating when you're fired by somebody who is clearly and markedly superior to yourself. And that just wouldn't be the case with you, Norman. See, you're just an ordinary Joe. As a matter of fact, we checked out your home life. You have absolutely nothing anyone could possibly envy or resent.
I'm honored, sir. But it just sounds like a horrible job, frankly.
It's a 300% raise, and if you don't take it, you're fired.
Sir, I will have you know that I cannot be bought, and I cannot be threatened. But you put the two together, and I'm your man.